PGA DFS fans, thanks for joining me for another one of my top five videos. This is the top five for the Olympics. It's kind of cool to say. A little bit of a change of pace from what we've been doing the last couple of months. I mean, it's been a long time since we've had a no-cut event. We got to go all the way back. I mean, maybe even the WGC concession. That was back in March. I mean, we had the match play, which was kind of like it, but it's been a long stretch of brutal cut sweats each and every week, but a nice little change of pace here at the Olympics. Just 60 golfers to choose from. They will play all 4 days as long as they don't withdraw, but most people I would assume that are over there in Tokyo already will not be withdrawing. So let's go ahead and talk about my top five values that I see on the board here. Of course, let's check in and see how I did last week. And let me tell you, it was kind of a brutal week for the value video. We had two guys miss on the number. We had another guy in Doug Gim bogey the 18th hole to miss the cut by two instead of birdieing it to make the cut. Then we had Hank Lebioda easily get through the weekend, also eagling the last hole, only to withdraw Saturday morning. Now all that leaves is Jonathan Vegas, who came in a tie for second. So a bit of a mixed bag. Kyle Stanley missed on the number. Doug Gim, I already talked about. Lebioda withdrew. Robert McIntyre missed on the number after bogeying his 36th hole. It was on the ninth. It was a tough hole, don't get me wrong. But still, a bogey to miss is going to sting. Overall, if just one stroke each way on those golfers, it could have been a great week. Instead, it was a pretty poor week, even with the top five. All right, let's jump now right into the top five of this week. And because there's no course history here at Kasumegi, I'm going to screw that up until I hear it a couple of times and I haven't heard it yet. Country Club, no course history here. So what I've done is gone four recent starts of 4 weeks. So the first guy I want to talk about is Henrik Norlander. This guy is on a good stretch of golf. In fact, five straight made cuts. It came to a nice little climax there at the John Deere Classic, where he came in a tie for fifth, 28th and 38th, the two starts before that. Did not play last week, came over to here. And for Norlander, he's a good ball striker, as we see in the strokes gain rate, 67th off the tee, 36th on the approach, but does struggle on and around the greens. However, I will say, after looking at some of the pictures here of the course of each hole, doesn't look like it's too hard in terms of driving, so he should have plenty of opportunities this week. Henrik Norlander, 6,800, I think is a very good guy to start your lineups with, especially in the value section. Next, I want to talk about Ryan Fox. Of course, if you guys are constant players and have played in the majors and such, you know this guy's name. And if not, he plays on the European Tour quite a bit. He's coming in at $6,900 this week on DraftKings. Did not play last week. Couple weeks before that, 67th and 44th, so not quite as good as Norlander coming in, but we look at his strokes gain ranks on the European Tour this year. 47th off the tee, 19th approach, and 13th around the green. So for Fox, if we just get a good putting week, he's going to be right there, at least based off of his strokes gain number. So Ryan Fox, he's my number two value on the board, or four, depending on which way you want to look at it. Okay, the next two, well, they're going to be hot topics this week because they just came off of the golf course, or so it seems, on Sunday in Blaine, Minnesota. We'll catch the first flight that they can. I don't know when it's going to get them to Tokyo. Looks like Patrick Reed is the other guy in this. Three of them, Mito Pereira, who we're going to talk about now, Jonathan Vegas, who we're going to talk about next, and Patrick Reed are the three. Looks like they're probably not going to get a chance to play the golf course before playing it in play on Wednesday during competition. So take this with a grain of salt. But if they continue the recent form that they've been doing, let's start with Mito Pereira, 7,200 on DraftKings. He's sixth and fifth the last 2 weeks on the PGA Tour. We go back 6 weeks. He's got a couple of wins on the Korn Ferry Tour, which got him onto the PGA Tour. Still only three or four starts here, so no strokes gain rank for Pereira. But still, the recent form is undeniable and the price is great. So if we don't worry, if he gets there, which we expect he will, if he gets there, there's no COVID problems, none, nothing like that. I do like Mito Pereira quite a bit this week. All right, I've already previewed Jonathan Vegas. I'm going to keep him on here again. 7,400 on DraftKings this week. Listen, that's just too cheap. Now he could end up coming in as one of the highest owned players on the slate, but it's warranted. The guy has played great golf, a runner-up last week. Obviously, at the 3M Open, a couple weeks before that, he came in 11th. A couple weeks before that, he had another top 10 in there. So for Jonathan Vegas, I think the price is just trailing too far behind. It's going to present really good value. There's plenty of opportunities to diversify your lineups so that even though he's going to be 30, maybe 40% owned in certain contests, you can diversify out elsewhere. Now, let's see why he's been so good this year. It's really been off the tee. Strokes gain rank there is fourth this year. Maybe after last week, even a little bit better. 100 on the approach, 159 around the green, and 174 putting. All right, last guy I want to talk about has been an underperformer this year. But at $8,600, you've got to start to take a look at him, especially in a no-cut and this type of field where it is top-heavy. But Tommy Fleetwood, we've seen him priced much higher in this situation. He's coming in at $8,600 this week on DraftKings. And recent form is decent. He's had three straight top 30s, 17, 26, and 33 in the 3 weeks leading up to last, where he took off, obviously, to get here. And he's probably been the most vocal about enjoying the Olympic experience and how excited he is to be here. Will that translate into a win? Of course, we don't know. But at $8,600, certainly somebody we got to look at. Strokes gained ranked this year, why he hasn't been good? Well, because he's only been better than average in around the green, which he's been phenomenal at, ranked fifth. The other categories, 154th off the tee, not great. 104 on the approach, that's a little better than average. And 118 putting is probably right on the average. So Tommy Fleetwood looking for a breakthrough this week. It's been a bad season, but if he throws in a bronze, silver, or gold, it might squash just a little bit of those bad feelings. So let's go 5-1 again. Henrik Norlander, Ryan Fox, Mito Pereira, Jonathan Fagus, and Tommy Fleetwood are your top five values for the Olympics. Kind of cool to say that, not going to lie. Hopefully we'll get to for the foreseeable future. So till next time, everybody, of course, join Ben Raz and I. We're going to be going on at 7:30 tonight. That's Monday. I'm recording this Monday morning-ish, probably seeing it before then. If you haven't seen it, and it's, say, Tuesday or Wednesday, and you're watching this video, go ahead and check our strategy show. You can get it, of course, on your favorite podcast provider or by going through the YouTube link and scrolling down to our golf videos and watching it there on playback. So until next time, everybody, good luck this week at the Olympics. Of course, stay tuned for my top five sleepers and top five fades this week. So until then, everybody, good luck, and we'll see you on the other side. Cheers.